was nice. It's nice to get the top of the bag. All that dry, beautiful charcoal right there on the top. See if I can do it one match. I got cardboard and paper down there. Now it's December 26th, and it's probably 75, 80 degrees out here. I got it. They brought us a new phone book. You really don't need phone books anymore. You got Google. But that phone book might do a good job of lighting the Royal Oak this morning. Royal Oak really is the best charcoal in the world, without a doubt. It's won a lot of championships. Well, let's let it burn for a little bit. Let's go over here and get on our big old 20-pound brisket this morning. Now, we got our CHOPS power injector this morning. Boy, I'm lucky to have one again. I got a fella coming that I'm going to give to as part of a deal if he gets back in touch with me. I probably need to get in touch with him. But man, that CHOPS power injector makes it really easy to inject. You know, if you're out there and you got a catering business or a barbecue business, CHOPS power injector is the way to go. They got the electric injector now, and that thing's really awesome. All right, we got our gloves on. Let's get our knife out and go ahead and start trimming our 20-pound brisket. Holy camoly, what in the world? Now we're going to be using Elk Creek Thank you. Okay, we're back. Man, I had to go get myself a big drink of water. Elk Creek. That's some really good beef. Well, it says it's good for beef, pork, chicken, and game. It is really good. I like it. We're gonna rock and roll Elk Creek this morning. He's got something good going on. Got our chopped power injector. We're gonna be using sweet smoke Q juice and butcher barbecue beef. Gonna rock a little bit of that. We're gonna get some of this fat off of this big, beautiful brisket this morning. I think it'll cook up good. Get that rule of oak on it. Some of this. You want to appear on the Barbecue Superstars Cooking Channel, all you got to do, let me know. BBQSuperstars@gmail.com. Now we're going to work a little bit of this kernel off right here. We call it a kernel. It's just a big old hunk of fat. None of the point's got a lot of meat on it, thank you, Lord. I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. We're doing this the day after Christmas. It's probably 75 degrees out here. It's supposed to be 30 degrees, 15, that kind of stuff. I'm ready to get my shorts out and jump in the pool. BCA rock and roll. Craig Sherry is the new president, the executive director, if you will. They got some good people in the IBCA. Good, decent people. Doing a competition prep, you want to pretty much take the point down to nothing so you can get some good burnt ends. One thing about beef fat, it gels, it doesn't render off. Well, in a Wagyu, it'll melt off. You go low and slow on a Wagyu, it'll melt the fat off of it like pork, and then you'll have a dried out brisket. You have to cook it hot and fast. There's a different color. Because it run through some water. Now, people age briskets, you know, 30 days, 45 days. Wet age them means they put it in plastic. Dry age them means they didn't put it in the refrigerator and hung it. They say if you age them a little, It'll make the meat better. But be honest with you, our seasonings are so good now. I mean, the seasonings are so good that really a lot of that you can throw out the window now. I'm gonna take a little cap off to get to expose this side. I mean, you got stuff like Elk Creek, which I tasted the other day. It is a superior rub, but you know, Big T. Big T's got deep tissue massage, a heck of a brisket rub. And, okay, let's go down this edge. Now this edge here looks the way it does because they hit it with hot water to kill the bacteria. And I'm gonna go ahead and take that little bit of edge just off. Don't waste a whole lot of it. That's big time good meat, you know. Now I'm gonna do a corned beef soon on the air live and put it on the cooking channel. Cooking corned beef's cool. It's about putting it in pink salt. They got a pink salt. I got it on the cooking info part of Barbecue Superstars. You put it in pink salt and water and a brine, and you brine it. There's some other ingredients involved. You can turn this thing just as orange pink as you want to. Okay. There's a little bit on the front, on the top, but not a whole lot. Well, that's a great big old brisket. Yeah, we'll get in here. And I got a nick there. If I did that or not, I don't see how I could have done it. You leave that much membrane and fat on there, right there, it'll keep the rub from hitting it. Some of it'll be burnt off in the process of cooking. Look at that big one right there. Man, the meat's right there. Ain't a whole lot of fat on this side. How about that? This is a 20-pound brisket. Hell yeah. Now, boy, can you see that flat? I gotta take a picture of that. That is an awesome flat right there. Phones have gotten about so good that you don't hardly have to, you don't have to buy a camera anymore. Boom, there's the flat. I got enough meat to really get rid of that whole membrane there, but dang, I hate to waste the dang meat off the top of that pretty flat. There's a big membrane coming down right across here though. Membranes inhibit flavor. Flavor doesn't touch the meat. Okay. Now this part here is a little bit thick, so I'm gonna go ahead and take off. I hope this whole thing right here in the kernel, I hope there's some meat in there somewhere. If it ain't, then I see why it's 20 pounds. No, it's all fat. That big kernel of fat. Now, you can sell that to a lard company. They can make lard out of it. One a big 12 inch. Oh, it ain't that bad. Big 12 inch Frederick Dick comes in handy. Frederick Dick makes the best knives in the world. Get you a grease stain. Encourage you. You're out there wasting $1,000 a week on a barbecue competition. Trying to start yourself a catering business or take your trailer around and start selling barbecue. Stop wasting your money. Stupid shit. I'll teach you how to cook it. Get out there and figure it out on your own. Come up with your own rub and sauce, get your own unique flavor going. strip down this a little bit more to get it down where the Elk Creek can hit it. Got an edge here. I want you to see that. Dig down to get a lot of that out of there. That's nothing but inhibiting flavor. A lot of membrane right there. Definitely want to get all the membrane off of there and get this down to the meat. Now we got the membranes off, we're just working really on the fat between the point and the flat. And you know, this ain't no barbecue competition. I'm not going to strip it all the way down to nothing because I want to feed as many people as I can with it. But just leaving a big hunk of pure flat, of pure fat in there is going to do nothing but inhibit flavor. So we may as well just blocking everything. I can actually get down in there and pull on it. It'll come loose from the meat. Pull on it, it'll break loose. I this off of there. That's thick enough here, I might just go ahead and strip some of it off. At least get the big hunk off. Now the more fat you take off of it, the less amount of time it takes to cook. So that's a consideration here. You get it all stripped down, you better watch when it's cooking, because it'll be done before you know it. I think I'm gonna leave the rest of this on to hold the injection in. Could take the knife and run it all the way over this, but I just don't want to lose that much meat, so I'm going to say that's good enough for a backyard cook. We get done putting all this flavor into it, it's going to be good enough, sure enough. Like a day in June out here. Dang. Everything's wanting to bloom and grass gonna start growing again. First thing, of course, we're going to do is inject. And I'm going to mix up my injection a little bit different today. We got our, holy caboli, hell yeah, Chops power injector. And we're going to open it up. Now the electric injector is for commercial use. I'll tell you what, you take your barbecue company to a whole nother level with that make sure I got my picture right. We fixing to go off with this Chops power injector. I'm going to start off with three cups of beer, and today I'm using Yingling. That's a quart of beer, no I'm sorry, 24 ounces of beer, three cups of beer. Beer goes with everything. Okay, now I'm gonna put a cup of sweet smoked cube beef. thing that's really good about that sweet smoked cube beef is you don't have to mix it and have to deal with the powder. Okay, and then I'm going to use the King of Brisket, Butcher Barbecue Brisket injection. We got it for sale on Barbecue Superstars right now. And man, this right here is some good stuff. Big as this brisket is, it's a 3/4 cup, it's 2 cups. Let me make sure that's right now. 3/4 cup with 2 cups of water. I'm gonna go ahead and put a whole cup in there because that's for 12-pound brisket. This is a 20-pound. I'm gonna put a whole cup up in here. Oh, that smells good. So good. Whoa, man, I can smell that beef flavor just hitting me in the face. Damn, pouring powder is not as easy as pouring liquid. I wasted a little bit. Damn, can't waste that. That's gold right there. Now, the good thing about a chop, now I put the liquid in first. Let me point that out to you, because it'll drop down on liquid rather than the bottom, and you got stuff sticking to the bottom. So always put your liquid in first. The cool thing about a chop's power injector is, whoa, shake it up. I ain't got to get something to stir it, shake it. Shake it up, baby. Shake it up, baby. Twist and shout. Now this is the half a gallon right here. We got 3 cups of beer, 1 cup of Butcher Barbecue beef, and 1 cup of sweet smoked cube. Now, it doesn't matter what you're cooking on. You can always use a chopped power injector for injecting meat. Put it on the gas grill. You know, if you got yourself a charbroil, put it in a charbroil. Oh! Well, let's do this. Now you can see that. That injection going up the hose right there. Look at there, that's a new thing. One piece. Yeah, let's. Prime it just a little bit. Whoa, what? I'm gonna go with the grain to start with. Whoa! Cool thing is, you can like. Look at that whole thing blowing up. Chop power injector. What the hell? This ain't blow it up quick. Man, it spreads that injection out. You can see a whole area raising up. You gotta be getting more in there using the chops. Man, I got these for sale. This is number one selling thing on Barbecue Superstars by far. Man, look at there. Boy, I sure have missed the chops power injector. I probably don't need to pump it up, but the way it's blowing up so good, I'm wanting to just blow it out. Blow it up. Whoa. It'll come back on you too now. Look at all that pressure. Whoa, look, watch this. Watch this. Oh, big as a balloon, how far we're going. Whoa. Man, look at there. Now I'm going to go counter the dang, I done put about all that in there already. I don't know if I really need to turn it over or not, but I'm going to. You don't want to put pressure on the meat once you inject it, start injecting it. Push it back out, but no, I didn't see any come out. But funny, the whole thing lifts up. It's like a whole area blowing up. You know, you can't inject as good without using the chops. I mean, this thing is superior to injecting meat. Oh, I'm running out. Yeah, I ran out. Get down to the last drop. Wow. Look at there. That's about a quart in that brisket. Blew it up like a balloon. I didn't lose much either. It's all in the brisket. All right, now it's time to do a workout. Elk Creek SEA, used by Top Cooks. Elk Creek. Ooh, it comes out good. I love it when a rub rolls out. Put a little bit on this fat cap. It ain't gonna do a whole lot of good, but we're not gonna leave it out. There, ooh, that smell, Elk Creek. Elk Creek, hell yeah. I used it on steak the other day and it blew my mind. That stuff was so good. It's got a wonderful smell to it. Us a picture of that beautiful brisket with Elk Creek on it. Flip-a-rooney. Shake it up, baby, shake it up, baby, twist and shout. twist and shout, come on, come on, come on, baby, now. Somebody said, just put enough on you can see through and see your meat. Can I get a bull jive? Put some rub on it. It's hard to season meat anyway. Need to put some rub on it, see. Get that flavor coming through on it. Sides. There's six sides to any piece of meat. Top, bottom, side, side, front, back. Six sides. Gotta do every side of it. Uh-oh. Elk Creek loaded down. Man, what a smell. Smells good. That beautiful smell is filling the air. Love's in the air. Elk Creek love is in the air. Elk Creek love is in the air. Hey, look at it, just soaking and sucking it in. 15 minutes. 15 minutes of Elk Creek love. What you need. Now I've got Big T. And top side of this, I wanted to give him some play today because I haven't been able to get a brisket to, do it with. Yeah. I don't mean to ruin the elk. I probably ought to just do Elk Creek. Don't throw nothing in there with it, but this Big T is good. And I've been wanting to give me some play. Wow, that's got some big chips on it. I think that's coarse salt. It's got some serious seasoning to it. Big T! Big chips and good flavor. And I get a little creek on that. Now we got that. Elk Creek and Big T on there. Well, I think one thing I figured out, phone book don't burn too good. I should have, get somewhere now. There you go, now we got a little contact going. A little something, something. Alright, we're off chop power injector out. Elk Creek out. I'm gonna pull over here and get our roll rope going. Molly. Molly, what in the world are you doing? What are you doing, Molly? Must be something on there that tastes good. I ain't got nothing to do with the food, but I'm gonna put a little more roll rope down in here because it's gonna take a while for this thing to cook. I'm gonna put a little load of roll rope in there. Now at 250, this amount of charcoal will last 24 hours. And this thing here cooks an extended amount of time with really controlling the airflow. That's the advantage of an Iron Man cooker. It's a great competition cooker. The great backyard cooker. If you don't have a huge catering or you got about 4 or 5 of them, it's a good, it's a fantastic catering cooker, but you'd have to have, you know, some of them to get the surface area up to paying more attention. I tell you, you get two, three, or four of these Iron Man cookers. If you got four, so you could do all four categories of meat in an IBCA or an FBA cook. I mean, you could run them all different temperatures. Have different airflow. but it is hot. It got it. That Royal Oak likes easy. Newspaper and all that, you know, they sell against lighter fluid. A lot of people use lighter fluid though. Ain't no big deal. Just keeping it real. It's a great big old brisket. Man, look at that beautiful smoke rolling around it. That's what you want right there. I'm going to let this thing cook for a full 3 hours. Right now it is 10:11, and we're gonna let it cook until 1:11, and I'll come back out and we'll check it. Let it go ahead and get some bark on it, get some flavor going. That's what we're doing. That's what we're doing, y'all. Royal Oak Iron Man Cooker, Elk Creek. That's some good brisket going down. Be back at 1:11. Okay, we're 3 hours into our cook, and our brisket's looking good, like a cowboy should. It runs around 275, but now it did get up to, it spiked up to 400 at one point. brisket will be good. Starts getting liquid on the top of it, like right there, right there. That's when you're supposed to wrap it. Like a cowboy should. Let's move this thing. This is real live television, folks. I'm really doing this right now. This ain't no damn. Did it 3 weeks ago, edited bullshit, or a month or 6 months. This is happening right now. Yeah. Holy shit. That looks as good as a red border tequila. I'm gonna get a little more Elk Creek put on here. That's a big brisket. I ain't gonna put no butter or nothing on it. Put a little bit more of this sweet smoke cube juice. I don't have to go mixing up a lot of stuff and do a lot of work. All I gotta do is just pick up a bottle and pour it. I've been cooking about 300 for 3 hours. Now, I'm gonna cook it for 3 or 4 more hours, or 4 more hours. At 300 degrees. There's plenty of juice in the brisket, but it'll be full of moisture by the time we get ready to pull it. So we'll come back at 4:11. 4:11. 4:30. No, we'll come down at 4:11. Check it again. 4:30. Fill this grill up. Elk Creek, hell yeah. That's what you use with it. Old Ray's steak and brisket. That stuff is good, good.